In this video, I'm going to show you how to handle yes or no fields in a pivot table. I have data here, and this firm has a number of restaurants, and they have been handing out satisfaction surveys to these restaurants. And they would like to know the reason why, or the locations where they're getting good response, and the locations that they're getting poor response. And so to start a pivot table, I always click in your field of data, and I go to insert on your menu bar, and I insert a table. And it's a plain ordinary table to start with. And I make sure that my table has headers is checked here. You say okay. And so there you have your data. So now I would like to create a pivot table out of this. So I'm going to go to my insert tab again, and I'm going to drop down table, and I'm going to select pivot table. And I'm going to put this on a new sheet, and that'll be fine. And so what I'm going to do is I am going to put the restaurant location in the rows column, or in the rows field here. So I'm going to drag it down to the there. And then I am going to select the survey. And I'm going to put that into the values. And it says count of surveys. But if you notice here, everybody got a survey. And so, this doesn't indicate whether they're yes or no, they've completed the survey or not. It just said that these were handed out. So let's go back to our sheet one. Let's look at the data that we have here. So if you look at the survey, it says yes or no. It doesn't say yes, we sanded one out and nothing for the other one. So let's create another field here. Let us go yes. And then we're going to do a simple if statement. We're going to go equals, and we're going to go if, and I'm going to go opening bracket, and I'm going to select this server, this field here, and I'm going to say if it equals quotation marks yes, and if quotation marks, I'm going to put a comma, and I'm going to say if it says yes, then we're going to put a one there. And if it says no, we're going to put a zero there. And then I press enter, and that will go through. And so now we have number of yeses there. And so let's go back to our sheet three where our pivot table is. Let's go to the data tab here, and let's go refresh all. And so now what we're going to do is we're going to take the count of survey out because we know that they had surveys, and we're going to put the yes in there. We're going to click on the yes, and we're going to drag it down to the values, and it's the sum of yeses. So this is a much more accurate representation of how many surveys that were returned by the customers as opposed to those that were handed out. So let's go to the Analyze tab here, and let's put in a pivot chart. And this one looks fine. And so there you have the locations of your restaurants and the total number of surveys that were completed by the customers. So this is how you handle a yes/no field in a pivot table. Please subscribe.